Hello everybody. In this video I'm gonna show you the things you should do when you buy a new computer, a new Windows computer I should say. Whether it's a laptop or a desktop, it's all the same. These are the things that would make your experience better with your new device. This is a laptop that one of my friends bought. He asked me to add some memory to it, so upgrade from 4 to 8 gigs. That's not relevant for this video, but I figure I might as well just do a nice cleanup job for him while I'm at it anyway. And what do I mean with cleanup job? Well, if you buy a computer from one of the big brands, this is an HP, but the same goes for Dell or Lenovo or Fujitsu or whatever, Asus. And this is especially true for consumer machines. Those companies pre-install all kinds of stuff that you probably don't want. So if I go to the start menu, what do we got here? We got the booking.com app, we got Dropbox, we got some energy star, I don't know, I don't even know what this is. Maybe it's some information thing. No, it's just a link to a web page. Well, you know, that's installed in the start menu, and like, have you asked for that? Probably not. Let's see what else we got. We got LastPass. Well, I happen to be a big fan of that software, but it comes pre-installed. If I want that, I'll put it on there myself. Same with the antivirus. You know, it's always a trial version, and so, you know, there's a lot of stuff in pre-installed that you've never asked for. That's one thing. I'm going to show you in a little bit how to get rid of that and get a completely clean Windows. But the very first thing I like to do is install the latest version. So we open up the browser. We search for Windows 10 Update Assistant. Auto-filled it already, and then there we go, the Microsoft update, the May update, so that's 2021 H1, so this one came out a week ago as of the making of this video. And since we're in the Netherlands, I'm getting the Dutch version of this page. But if you're in your country, you'll get it in your own language. So you'll click the Update Now button. You download a little file. You open it. And then you click Update Now. It checks whether your computer is ready for the update. You click Next. And you run it and you let it complete. This will generally take between half an hour and an hour and a half or so. It depends on how old the version is on your computer and how fast the computer is also. So we're just gonna skip this part and we're gonna come back after this update has been installed. You basically just let it run, let it update, then it has to restart a couple times, and it does take a while, so that's normal. So just let it do its thing and have patience. And here we are again. And the first thing that I do is go to settings. See this crap pop up that I didn't ask for. And then we click on update and security. And we check for updates again, because sometimes it has a bunch of updates ready to go right after doing a big one. And there you go, there it is. So let's do all these updates. I never install the optional ones because that's basically a beta version. And you are doing testing for Microsoft on your own computer. And I don't think that's necessary. Most of the time they'll probably be fine, but if you do these optional updates, there's always a chance that something goes wrong, because you'll be one of the very first people installing those. And I mean, you can do it, but I would always advise against it. And normally those updates will come to you in a normal way after a month or so. So there's no real reason to do those. And with the way Windows Update is now anyway, there's no reason to check it manually, because it just does it automatically in the background. So, but because we're doing a clean install soon, I want to have all the lids update, so we have a truly up-to-date machine that's completely fresh and ready to go. You go to the start menu and you right click on it and you get the secret menu, and then you click on Windows PowerShell admin. You get the elevated command prompt. You click yes, and now you are in PowerShell. It is possible that your computer is in S mode, which means it basically only allows you to run apps that are in the store. And you might get a different prompt, and then you click on more options, and it takes you to the Microsoft Store that lets you install an app that takes you out of S mode. And after you do that, you restart the computer and you'll have this option. And now you type the following command: systemreset space dash cleanpc. Enter. Now you're in the fresh start menu. You click next and it shows you everything that gets removed. That's okay with us, because that's everything, that's exactly what we want. Click next again, click start, sit back and have a coffee, because this takes another good while. And after this is complete, you can see that we have a completely clean computer. All the crap is gone, we just have the standard Windows applications. And what's now left to do is install the HP support assistant. Why is this important? Well, certain drivers can only be obtained through the management software of the computer, and for HP this is the support assistant. For Lenovo is I don't know what it's called, but it's I think the Lenovo computer manager or something. Anyway, it's this one application that basically gives firmware updates and driver updates to your laptop that's specific to the vendor of the machine. Windows is good at downloading and installing drivers by itself, and you can see that we have WIFI, we have sound, so all that is taken care of. But it's possible that sometimes a firmware update for your BIOS or another motherboard chip arrives, and that usually gets pushed only through the support application of that laptop. So I'm going to open up the browser and go to HP support assistant, and you can see that Bing is the standard search engine, because we're using the new Edge. And it found what I asked it to find, so I guess it's not that bad. Let's see, where is it? HP Support Assistant. Download the Support Assistant. Okay, it's finished downloading, let's open it. We get the elevated command prompt. We allow the app to be opened, because, you know, it's from HP and we trust them. Otherwise, we hadn't bought a laptop from them either. So there we go. It's installed. Oh, I guess I opened setup twice. Let's see, support. There it is. Open it up. I'll continue as a guest today. Let's see if there are any updates. Let's see, I want updates for everything. Bring it on. Weekly schedule to check. Well, Sunday night, the computer's most likely not turned on, so let's check every Tuesday at 11 o'clock. Okay. And it looks like Windows has installed and found everything there's to find. That's great. Windows has really gotten a lot better at pushing drivers or getting drivers from vendors that push to laptops and desktops directly. So that's a good thing that we actually don't really need this application anymore, I guess. But yeah, there you go. Clean computer. No bloatware anymore. Now you can enjoy a fast machine with no crap running in the background that you never asked for. If this video was useful, be sure to check out the rest of my channel. I have a podcast called Diederik's Beach Bar with lots of interesting guests and subjects. Be sure to check that out. There's probably something for you there too, because I talk to a very wide range of people. So check that out, and I have some more technology videos like this, and I'm also talking photography in some videos. So if any of this sounds interesting to you, check out the rest of my channel and subscribe and like and all that stuff. Hope this was useful, and I wish you a good day.